coffee.
Mega supercomputer.
HiPerGator.
Prompt engineering.
Digital twins.
A little robot companion.
Artificial intelligence.
A brain.
I mean, computers are not smart.
I have no more money. As we sit here 4,000 feet in the bunker below the surface of Gainesville, seeking the optimal cup of coffee, we've discovered that this ain't the place. but I do appreciate the mug, Mr. CIO, and just for the people who are out there watching, this is a Navigator AI mug, and Navigator is a unique product that we have here, isn't it?
Yes, it's the University of Florida Generative AI Gateway.
Okay, let's cut through all that jargon, okay? Yeah. I'm more curious about how it operates, because when you interact with ChatGPT and similar large language models, it talks to you like a real person. Is it thinking like a real person?
No, it's not a real person.
What is it?
It's an Uber recorder that have captured a lot of what's available on the internet and organized it in such a way that it could give it to you back a little faster, somewhat organized based on what the prompting of the questions are.
So it's not operating like the human brain?
No, it's not. Part of the human brain involves memory.
Yes.
And this is all about capturing information that's already known and spitting it back to you a lot faster than a human being could do it.
Being a mathematician who specializes in probability theory, I'm trying to get you to say it's all based on probability theory and probabilistic relationships among phrases and which word follows which
word. It's all based on what you just said.
There you go. Okay. We're done.
Every aspect of what we do on campus is used by this machine. It supports about $670 million of the university total research portfolio. So our faculty really depends on it very, very heavily.
How is the campus environment going to change for students because of HiPerGator?
So the students do indeed care about it because they are around using it in their courses.
I wanted you to talk about agents and the coming of the agents. What are agents and what are they going to do?
Well, the students are now dealing with agents, yeah. So the next evolution of generative AI, which is what you're going to see in 25 and 26, is the population of agents, AI agents, where they're basically, if you're familiar with assistants, agents are the next level where an agent could autonomously do things. They actually take action, not only give you information.
So when I come to the University of Florida as a freshman, 5 years from now, am I going to get a little robot companion that's going to come with me and be my friend and help me study and learn my material and play lacrosse with me at the end of the day?
I don't know about a little robot, but we are hoping in 5 years, the students, when they get here, they have their personal assistant. So we will say to them, welcome to the University of Florida, here is your here's your digital twin assistant that can help you with your study.
Great, so it can go to class instead of me if it's my digital twin.
Yeah, probably it can. It'll probably do better.
I don't doubt that. I don't doubt that at all. And now we're sitting here talking with Erik Deumens, the Director of Research Computing at the University of Florida. And we're going to explore the parallels between the brain and HiPerGator, or the differences a little bit more. Can you give us some idea of the difference between HiPerGator and the way the human brain would operate?
The way you have to compare a computer with the brain happens at two levels. And artificial intelligence is very focused on one level, which is when you really want to compare the function of the brain and in its basic. Artificial intelligence people even use the same word as what we had in our brains, neural networks, because they have this similarity. And it's electricity. And it turns out that we do all these transformations, but in the end, it all turns into heat. Our brains work on chemistry. So there are some molecules that are all in. So I was actually only giving you the first part of my answer, which is comparing the normal function of a human brain with sort of replicating it on something like HiPerGator.